thank Showtime, first and foremost, for working with us for his last three events. We want to thank Gila River Arena or Desert Diamond Arena. And most of all, we want to thank Anderson Silva for accepting this fight and putting on the tremendous performance that he did. As far as all the media here, we really appreciate you. This business doesn't exist without you. So thank you for being here. Thank you for continuing to support Jake. Go ahead.
Jake over here. You've obviously long admired Anderson Silva, and you knew you said yourself you were going to win this fight all week. But now that is a reality, what are the emotions now that you've defeated one of your childhood heroes?
It's surreal. I don't think it'll hit me until like a couple weeks from now. I feel like I'm living in a movie. You know, he was the one that told me I could accomplish anything if I set my mind to it. You couldn't have written this in a story. It feels like a movie. And just being in the ring with him, seeing his heart, you know, his courage, his bravery. That's the champion that I looked up to, and he's such an inspiration. And, you know, I had to go in there and match his heart tonight, a heart that I saw through the TV screen when I was a kid. So it's just surreal and doesn't make any sense, to be honest.
And that punch that dropped him, you said after when you knocked out Tyron Woodley, you saw him, you're trying to catch that punch, and then you came over the top and dropped him. So when you did drop Anderson, was that an opening you knew you could take advantage of it?
I mean, we were throwing shots all night, and that one just caught him off guard when he was coming up. So we were just throwing, and he was taking harder shots than that. That wasn't even the hardest punch of the night. It was obviously just the timing. I was just surprised by his toughness, because I was dropping sparring partners all camp with those shots to the body and shots to the head. He's built different. You know, the guys fought through broken bones and all sorts of stuff. So to beat someone like that, you got to dig deep, and that's what I did tonight.
Hey, Jay. Penny Buffington from MMA Fight Coverage. I'm trying to come up with the words to express how impressed I am with you. Absolutely amazing what you have done, coming from the YouTube days, and now we're on Showtime Sports. The whole entire event is because of you, Jake Paul, and I'm beyond impressed with that. I'm kind of picturing what it's like for you to choose your next opponent. It's like the Jake Paul lottery. Who's going to win next? Who gets to fight you? Are you bombarded with requests to fight? And how do you handle that? How do you go through that list of...
Yeah, look, I think this fight did two things. It'll make a much higher level people want to fight me, and it'll make the ones who are already scared, you know, like we saw earlier this year, they're not going to want to fight me. So we'll see. That, you know, I'm sure there's a lot of names. I haven't even gone on Twitter yet to look at everything and all the call-outs, but I'm sure there's going to be a lot. And it's back to the drawing board, and we'll see who it is. But, you know, Nate Diaz was here acting like a bitch. Everyone wants that fight. He tried to fight people in the hallway. You know, Nate, stop fighting people for free. Let's do it in the ring, okay? I know you're a little slow, buddy, but it's okay. We can make that fight happen. And you too, Canelo. You're getting old. You looked weird against Triple G. I still want that fight as well. And I think now, like I said it 18 months ago, oh, well, Canelo. And then everyone, I was sitting in a room just like this, and everyone was like, oh, fucking idiot. And then now, 18 months later, here we are. And when I say that, maybe people are taking it a little bit more seriously now, and I still mean it, and I still want that fight.
Are you the one that strictly makes those decisions? Are you the one that's actually powering through those requests and choosing? Do you actually have someone in your mind that you kind of want and you go for, or do you go through those requests? And
all of the above, and it just, you know, who makes sense at the right time and who actually wants to do it and who will actually show up and be a professional and make weight. But it is who I want, you know. Even people on my team, my coaches and stuff, were like, well, are you sure you want Anderson? Are you sure? And I was like, yes, I can do this.
Okay, well, I know that Joe Briggs has been calling you out. Is he someone that you've considered?
I don't know who the fuck that is.
I was afraid you were going to say that, which I find kind of funny because anyone who knows Anderson Silva definitely knows who Joe Riggs is, and he's local. So, I mean, I just think that would be a perfect matchup for you, and I hope it's something that you'll consider.
Thank you.
Jacob Redder. Congrats on the win tonight, man. You mentioned Nate Diaz, and we've seen video already of this incident. It seemed like he slapped a member of your team. It's hard to tell. Can you elaborate on what happened?
I haven't seen the video, and I didn't really know what happened. I just know there was an altercation with my team.
Jake wasn't even aware of the altercation before the fight.
Yeah, I was focused on what was going on, but I was made aware of it afterwards, and it's you know, typical of him. That's what he likes to do. He's a street gangster. He likes to act tough, and he's really not. Like, why are you trying to beat someone up in a hallway, bro?
I mean, speaking of the MMA community, you and the MMA community have a very interesting relationship, you know, over these last few years. You just beat a genuine legend of the sport, probably one of the greatest fighters of all time. Like, how do you feel like, is this the win you think that would get you the respect of that community?
I think it has to. You know, I want to watch the fight back, but, you know, people were just saying it was a really good fight, a brawl, a war, awesome back and forth. And so I think people will respect my game. I showed different parts of my arsenal, you know, defense, all of that, fighting on the inside with a legend who's really good at fighting on the inside. I think this fight definitely has to gain me some respect, you know, and I'm only 2.5 years in. So this is just the start. I'm just getting warmed up with what I can accomplish. And this is the first fight in my career where, like, I felt comfortable in the ring, right? And to just think about it. No one 5 fights in is fighting 8-round fights. No one. You know, that's, they build them up 4 rounds, 6 rounds. I mean, Tommy Fury is still fighting 6-round fights, right? And he grew up his whole entire life doing this sport, right? And his brother's the heavyweight champion of the world. My brother, and I are fucking from YouTube. So I'm doing something that no one's ever done before, and I'm just learning my bearings in the ring, but we'll see what happens after this.
But I want to add, he loves the MMA community, right? He loves MMA fighters. He loves trying to be a spokesperson for the sport and bringing it along with himself. Of course, he's honest. He wears his thoughts on his sleeve, and he'll attack someone if he sees something that he doesn't agree with. But make no mistake, Jake Paul is a huge fan of MMA.
I was a fan of MMA before boxing. Yeah, and so, you know, and guys like Anderson Silva, so.
Keith Heiding from BoxingTeam.com. Congratulations.
Thank you.
As the rounds were unfolding, particularly in the second half of the fight, how close of a fight did you feel it was, and what did you think the scorecards would read, particularly after you got the knockdown in the 8th round?
I thought it was 6-2, which is what I think pretty much the judges had it scored as. My coaches were telling me in the corner, like, hey, you got that round. You didn't get that round. So, it was tough all the way throughout, a couple close rounds, and I knew I just had to keep on working and working and working, but after I got the knockdown, I knew that I had it in the bag.
Hey Jake, Ben Davis from MMA Island, congrats on the win. Deji expressed how impressed he was with your skills. No interest in KSI at this time?
Man. He won't fight me, especially after this fight. Like, guy needs to keep on playing FIFA and making shitty rap music. I don't really know what the guy does. He's fighting bums, trash cans. I'm trying to become a world champion.
He's respected the legend as well.
Yeah, and he's just like, I don't know what the fuck that kid's doing.
Jake Ray, Chris. Do you feel like this fight, that's just before, but, you know, with Anderson's age and him being in the third fight since he retired, I know you mentioned it in the ring, but do you feel like this is moving you closer to that boxing legitimacy, and you say you feel like a world champion. Do you think this fight moves you closer to getting to that point confidently?
For sure, for sure. When you get 8 hard rounds with a legend like Anderson Silva, it's just really good experience under the belt, right? And he just beat a former world champion, Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. He beat him 8-0. So he schooled the former world champion. So this definitely moves me in that direction. And this guy is insanely tough, insanely tough. So it's just great experience under my belt. And like I said, it's only been 2.5 years. So, you know, who knows what I can accomplish. I know, but I'll show you guys.
Jake. Two more for Jake, and then we'll let Anderson have the floor.
Jake right here. Andreas from Sporting News. The MMA community may love you, but do you have a message for Dana White? Because he was very critical of you taking this particular fight with Anderson Silva.
Yes, sir.
Dana?
Yeah.
Dana? Dana?
What?
Bro, you said I wouldn't do this. And I did it, and with flying colors. But you know, he's in hiding. You know, he's trying to do everything he can to stop my run, to sabotage my fights. He hates me. He hates me. He hates what I'm doing. He hates I'm exposing his business. And now, you know, we're gonna band together and create a United Fighters Association to help UFC fighters, all MMA fighters, and boxers to get more fighter pay, long-term health care. And that's a big, big undertaking that I've been wanting to do for the whole entire time of my career since I met Nikisa. I said it to him on the first day. I want to make a fighters union. So, man, Dana White can suck this dick.
Michelle Joy Phelps with Behind the Gloves, right back here, sorry. When you first started, obviously you started fighting other YouTubers. They still seem to be looming, as in like wanting to still call you out. There have been various names that have been mentioned, even from yourself. But as you're trying to edge towards, like you said, being a world champion, is that sort of becoming further and further away from you in making those type of fights as opposed to continuing to fight other combat fighters?
Yeah, no, for sure. I don't think any of the influencers will fight me or want to fight me. I've said that since, you know, a year ago, but especially now. And, you know, if someone makes sense, like a big name in the space, then maybe we can do something. But I want to fight big names. I want to fight boxers. I want to fight anyone who's going to give me a challenge where fans will be like, I don't know who's going to win this fight. Those are the fights I like to make. And that was exactly what we did here. I think the fight could have gone either way. There was ways where he could win and there's ways where I could win.
Hey Jake, right over here. I just have to ask because your brother was here, Logan. What did he tell you and what are you going to tell him for his Roman Reigns WWE fight? Did you inspire each other from tonight?
Yeah, man, he gave me a speech in the locker room. I love that man so much, and he just put it all in perspective as to what we are accomplishing together. And it's so amazing to have a partner in crime. The kid's a genius. He's such a kind person. I look up to him. He makes me a better person. He inspires me every day. And I can't believe next weekend he's going to take on another massive, massive name in combat sports in the WWE Championship. It's surreal what we're building. I think we might be the new Kardashians. Hey, who's going to... Never mind.
Jake,
real quick. You have got your hat. You have got your cheeks. What do you have for Anderson Silva, really quick? Just...
I got respect for him.
Oh, thank you, brother.
We do one picture for John.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Congratulations to both of you, man. How about just Phoenix as a fight city, the host of the crowd?
It was turned.
Thank you, Jake.